Stewart Pearce, Diana's voice coach and close friend, has said that the princess longed to move to California with her sons William and Harry before she died. Pearce, 68, broke his silence on the 24th anniversary of her death, revealing that Prince Harry's move stateside has been shockingly similar to his mum's dream. He explained that Diana wanted to forge a career behind the cameras, making movies rather than staring in them, unlike her daughter-in-law Meghan Markle. Pearce told the Daily Mail that there were a number of major projects brewing in her consciousness through offers that had been offered to her. But one of the major opportunities that she wanted to create was to start developing documentaries about three charitable interests that would then be assimilated into major movie pictures. She was planning on spending a lot of time in Hollywood. Pearce and the princess became close after he became her private voice and presence coach in 1995. At the time of her death on August 31, 1997, Diana was dating film executive Dodi Fayed, but Pearce dismissed speculation that she was pregnant or planning to marry him. In 2007, Diana's butler Paul Burrell also claimed that she wanted to jet off to California, to live in Fayed's Malibu mansion. She said, "This is our new life, just want it be great. Think of the lifestyle the boys. Nobody's judgmental here in America. You don't have the class system. You don't have the establishment," Burrell said. Although Diana was actually contacted by Kevin Costner regarding an acting role in a sequel to 1992 film The Bodyguard, Pearce insisted that she was not interested in on-screen roles. "She knew she was much better as a person behind the camera rather than in front of the camera," he said. He also claimed that she was in conversations with Hollywood executives about this dream, and added, "Everything she did was signed with the autograph of excellence," meaning she consulted the right people. "It was all about the highest echelon of opinions that could be maintained for the greatest project management. So I know whomever she employed or worked in liaison with, it would have been an excellent standard moving towards the possibility of an award-winning status. There is no doubt, she was all full of the action of co-creativity." For the latest breaking news and stories from across the globe from the Daily Star, sign up for our newsletter by clicking here.